Imagine if your walk to work in the morning would power the lights during your walk home in the evening. I'm an industrial design engineer, and I'm fascinated about the built environment and how to make our cities more sustainable. So I've got a little ask for you this afternoon, TEDx Berlin. Could everyone please stand up from their seats? Everyone, the whole audience, please. If you can stand up, right at the back there, please. Now, when I count to three, I'd like everyone to make a little jump, just like that. Don't jump too high. It's a little jump. Okay, so are you ready? Okay, so one, two, and three, and jump. Okay, thanks so much. You can take a seat now. Thank you. Get the blood flowing a bit there. So from that small little hop you all made, that's enough energy to charge, fully charge three smartphones. So it's showing the potential of, imagine if we all hopped all the time throughout my whole TED talk, imagine what could be done. I used to work for one of Europe's largest energy companies, and I was looking at how to create a new form of power in our cities that was a renewable source of energy. Obviously, looking at solar and looking at wind, everyone's very aware of the common issues with these forms. So I thought, what about a power source that was literally under our feet? That every step people make, if we could capture that. And I thought, think of all the millions of people in the world, think of all the hundreds of cities, and think about what could be created by it. So I created Pavegen. So Pavegen is a flexible paving slab that converts the kinetic energy of your footstep into electrical power. So it stores the energy from many people walking throughout the day, throughout the night in our cities. It's made out of recycled truck tires. The majority of the components are made from recycled materials. Now, I have a demonstration here with me today. A Pavegen contains a battery, a timer, and some wires. So you can imagine trying to fly it from London on a plane is not the easiest thing. But I got a demonstration here today. So as I stand on it, we can see 5% of the energy makes it light up in the center. Now, the rest of the energy is going into a light here. Now, obviously, I'm just making a few steps, but imagine all the hundreds of people walking in the built environment. Now, I've got a demo I'm going to do of showing how we can store the power of a few steps I'm making, and it's going to go into this light fitment here. So you can see that, you know, that light could be on all night just from a few people walking. Thanks. So I see this as a way that it can be a new low-carbon, you know, economy for our cities, powering the streetlights, powering applications on the street without needing connection to the grid, so completely off-grid and kinetic. Now, I'm going to talk about my journey. You know, we're at a really exciting stage today with Pavegen. We've just installed at the London Olympics at one of the busiest sites that feed people to the Olympic Park off the London Underground. But it all started with a sketch. So the wooden Pavegen is the first one I ever made, and it didn't really work very well. It showed the concept. I did it at Loughborough University in the UK. And I knew that I could see the potential. I wanted to try and take it further and understand more about it. So I took it to a school. I thought, there's a lot of people there, and they've got energy, so let's try it out. So I put a Pavegen at the school, and they found it interesting. And then they had a riot. So there's still a Pavegen there behind all the people trying to jump on it. So then I said, I really need to get it installed in a school a bit more permanently. So I did a legal installation in a school. I had no safety standards for the product. I had no approval to put it in there. And I didn't really know what would happen. But this is the first ever trial that we did. So I thought here, he finds it, you know, this student's quite fun. Have I invented the gamification of energy saving? Is that a good thing? So I'll go back to that point later, but it showed that, you know, they find it really, really fun and engaging. And now I'm going to show you my favorite machine. So this is a rain machine that simulates what it's like being outside for a Pavegen. It's not very fun. You get vandalized, people always jumping on you, you're going to get people vomiting on it. You know, it's really extreme environment and probably one of the hardest environments to engineer a product for. So also, stiletto heels. Now, what you'll see here is a 50-stone lady on stiletto heels on the slab. Now, I couldn't find a real one, so on the left we have a machine that simulated it. And that's all part of the process of getting an idea through to something that will actually, you know, really work. So we did our testing, we'd done our standards, and then the school that I had illegally installed in came back and said, we'd actually, you know, like a real one now. So I now have 1,100 students who have devoted their lives to destroying my technology. They've done it since 2010, and they haven't succeeded yet. So as they walk down the corridor, the lights in the corridor are powered from their steps. Now, I thought, you know, that's really exciting that it works in that environment. Where else can we use it? But after doing this, we had a small newspaper in the UK write a little bit about us. Then a few more newspapers and online publications wrote about us. And then everyone started writing about us. So then, after all this attention, and then suddenly we had Will I Am from the Black Eyed Peas. He wanted to have a dance on it. And even David Cameron wanted one in Downing Street. Unfortunately, he didn't have the money at the time, but he assured me he will soon. And then we went on with the awards. So don't get me wrong, awards are great. You feel really good when you walk around holding them. I'm not sure I ever look very good with them. But the thing about awards is it doesn't really matter. It's all about getting a real product, getting back to reality, and getting a product that actually works. So I said, okay, where else can we use this? What else can we do? So I said, well, where else in the world do people dance harder than here in Berlin? And the answer is, best of all, in the Isle of Wight. It's a festival with 70,000 people. I said, well, let's put it there, and let's see what happens. So I've got a short video to show you of what happened to us at Best of All. So we had over 1,000 mobile phones were charged in one weekend only. And I believe that one of the biggest polluters are fossil fuels. Now, did you know the average person at a festival uses 0.5 liter of diesel per day? So imagine 70,000 people there for 4 days. It totals up to a lot of energy. So my belief for this is to take it to a stage where a whole festival could be powered entirely by the very people dancing, walking, and running around it. So then I thought, could we take this to a city? So I had the opportunity to take it to Bulgaria, Spain, and Greece. So I took it to Sofia, the capital of Bulgaria, and this is what happened. So what you just saw there was the Minister of Energy for the Bulgarian government doing hopscotch down my walkway. We had over 200,000 people walk on it over 2 weeks, and it powered the streetlights in the area. So I'd looked at schools, because they were the easiest thing to do first. I'd taken it to a few cities in very small settings, and I thought, well, you know, what about transport? You know, all the millions of people moving through every major transport hub every day, there's a lot of potential. So in 2009, I spoke to some people who were involved in the rail networks, and I showed them this. I said, that'd be cool, you know, power the lights in a station from Pavegen. And I'm delighted to say that throughout the Olympic Games, we've had one of the most transformative types of installations of this technology. So I've got a short video to show you about what's happened in the past few weeks in London. So in the next 2 weeks, as the Paralympics finish, we'll hit our millionth footstep on a Pavegen. So with that energy, we're powering the lights along the walkway where we are. Now, this is a small-scale installation, but it's proven that it can work in, you know, really busy transport hubs. So another thing we thought about was, what else can you do with this? And I've looked towards things like smart cities as being a really exciting area. So we created a Pavegen that turns into its own data center. So it can send that information wirelessly, and you can use it. So throughout the Olympics, you can see how many slabs each Pavegen's got. You can name them. And then you can go and see a live feed, and you can see how many people have walked on it throughout the month every day, and really understand more. And the application lists are endless. I mean, the idea of gamification for this, it could go on and on and on. And we've just really first started to create a way where you can get accountability online for what happens on a floor. And eventually, the streets would talk to each other, and everywhere would be networked up together. So I've got a short video to show you next that something we created a few weeks ago of a way that we can demonstrate this. And we've got another demo that's going to happen live of a Pavegen. Okay, here we have the Pavegen Twitter test. Okay, come through here. We're in the Pavegen lab right now. Gilmore here has built a circuit that's going to convert the energy from a Pavegen into a signal that's going to send a live tweet from Hussein jumping on a slab. So Hussein, you ready?
Yeah.
Ready to go? Okay, ready? 1, 2, 3. Okay, let's see if it works. Okay, let's come through. Okay, so we're all hooked up here. We've got Jeff McDaddy ready. Tweet's just come in. Let's have a look at it. Jeff McDaddy says, "What up, Ted? Sent from a very cold and grey London from a Pavegen." Good work, guys. Great stuff. We got it. That well. Yeah, we sent the tweet. Yeah. So today I brought a special guest with me. It's my friend, the Ducky. The Ducky's going to send out, hopefully, a wireless signal from a Pavegen. So I'm just going to disconnect us and plug us into it here. I'm going to be joined by my very glamorous assistant, David, who's going to come to stage now. And the Ducky is plugged in now. And what we're going to do, when I stand on it, it's going to send a tweet. Okay, so I've stepped on it. Now, it's got an iPad up here. It's going to pick it up. Now, because everyone here there's quite a few iPads and laptops around, there's a bit of a delay on it. So what should happen is the tweet should come out, it should be refreshed, and we should get a message coming out from the Pavegen. So any second now, it's going to come. Oh, we got it. Oh, here we go. So here you can see. Can you read it out to me, David? There we go. So it worked. Get our technology. So I'll ask you all, see if you can find that tweet. So that was a human-powered tweet test. And it's a really exciting time, but a really crucial time. It comes down to the community, to you, to really help to spread the word and make a difference on kind of real transformative, like disruptive technologies such as this. So my aim is that this could be a technology that could be built into all of our cities, that could be a play a portion of the energy makeup, along with things like the smart grid and how that all comes together. So my dream is that when all of you walk to work over the next few years, every step you take will be on a Pavegen. Thank you very much.